Hello and greetings from Iceland, but today's video is all about the volcano Katla by the south coast. But only a week ago, some earthquakes were detected there in the caldera, so it occurred to me to make an update then, but I decided to hold on and get some more meat on the bones for that story, and that worked out. We got some more news yesterday. But first and most importantly, I made Katla volcano a part of my last photo tour, since I found this short weather window to work with. So I took off into the so-called summer here in Iceland. It could be better now. Like you see, plenty of rain this summer. So I found this clever sheep by the highway, but she had developed her own technique and used the guardrail to keep her head dry. But I drove over the highlands this time, shot all kinds of footage on the way, all the way to the town of Vík, just by the enormous volcano Katla. And I shot a full video from that town for the section of my channel that covers all Icelandic towns and villages. But as for the glacier by the town on the Katla caldera, it reaches an altitude of 1500 meters. It's often cloudy up there. So I knew that my only chance would be to drive up to the ice edge on a miserable road high up, and there I found myself in thick fog. But I did know about clear skies above the fog, so I took this chance to get some minutes of glacier flyover to use as b-roll in this video and other projects. And it took me a while to find this tiny little hole through the fog, and after some playing around up there, before I had to fly into this fog to find myself, I want you to notice this glacier tongue, because it became a part of yesterday's news from Katla. The glacier over Katla is called Mýrdalsjökull, but this part of it, this tongue, is called Sólheimajökull, and it is a popular tourist spot, or here, by the end of this glacier tongue, where the water accumulates, and then it created the shortest glacial river in Iceland, and it was in the old days called Fúlilækur, or Foul Stream, or Rotten Stream, or something like that in English. But that wasn't a nice name, especially when it comes to tourism. So we named it again, and the tourist-friendly version became Jökulsá á Sólheimasandi, or this beautiful and easy to remember name for a river. And the river was in the news yesterday. The conductivity in it has been on the rise, which represents a changed chemical composition in the water, and the water level is also unusually high for this time of year, and the smell of sulfur is in the air. So this triggered the warning systems, because those could be signs from a small eruption like we had under the glacier in 2011. But things seem to be cooling down again, so I'm not sure if this will turn into anything. But this is, however, a fine rehearsal for those of you who want every bit of information, but you already know about my earthquake live view links. But this time I'm adding a link to the webpage where you can see the live feed from all rivers in Iceland. And after login, you just have to look up Mýrdalsjökull glacier, and there we find all the rivers flowing from the glacier. Also the river with the tourist-friendly name Jökulsá á Sólheimasandi. And the plots show the water level, temperature and conductivity. So if there are any unusual movements under old Katla, this is the place to go to. And this was very usual in 2011, but it is believed that a small eruption occurred under the glacier back then, but it didn't make it through the ice. And I'm linking to very good information about that event that led to a huge flood that destroyed a large bridge near the town Vík. And we also have to bear in mind that we are getting closer to the shaky season. Late summer and early fall, that's when we often get strong earthquake swarms, since the glacier loses a lot of weight during the summer, so things have often been hectic around there in September. And Katla is the best monitored volcano in Iceland due to the proximity to the town Vík. And since I'm prepping you to be on the lookout for Katla, I did not find any webcam link this time. It used to be a live cam, but it's gone. But I'm sure that will change if things get shaky again. An eruption in Katla is at least 10 times more powerful than in 2010 Eyjafjallajökull eruption, but the last eruption was in 1918, over 100 years ago, but Katla erupts usually every 40 to 80 years, so this volcano is more than prepared. And I am leaving a link to a full documentary that I have about this mountain. It's a well-made documentary made by an Icelandic girl in Icelandic, but it has subtitles. But we are, however, always getting some new information about this volcano, like it is one of the largest volcanic sources of carbon dioxide on the planet, contributing up to 4% of global emissions from non-erupting volcanoes, or somewhere between 12 to 24,000 metric tons every day. And that's quite a lot. And finally, since I'm dedicating this video to Katla, I noticed the other day that one of our experts mentioned that we do get extremely large events, like every 300-400 years, or events of such scale that it would change the life around here permanently and cause major problems in the world. And why he chose to mention this now is a bit odd, for the simple reason that the worst case scenarios are hardly mentioned around here. And I think that many Icelanders are not aware of how extremely bad things can get. And there are three systems that might or can do us great harm, and Katla is one of them. And it is not just the Katla caldera we are talking about. So take a look at this, but this is actually not my own shot, but I'm on my way there with a drone soon. But this is one of the most spectacular volcano canyons in the world, or a 40 kilometer long chain of volcanic craters and fissure vents from the only known eruption from Katla outside the caldera. But this occurred during the 10th century, giving you an idea about the powers under there. And the fissure is up to 600 meters wide and 200 meters deep. And this eruption was the largest volcanic atmospheric pollution event of the last few millennia. And traces of platinum erupted by the volcano have been found across the Western Hemisphere, where they have been used to date archaeological sites. And the Eldgjá eruption produced, according to Wikipedia, 232 million metric tons of sulfur dioxide. And this is one of the events that we just don't talk so much about here in Iceland, but they occur every 300-400 years. But my guess is, however, that it would be Bárðarbunga rather than Katla that would send us the next eruption of this scale. But Katla did, however, get 100 years to reload now. The glacier is smaller than it has been for a long time. And when I noticed a few earthquakes on this old fissure from the 10th century, it occurred to me, without any scientific responsibility, or if Katla is simply having a problem to get the magma through the ice, and might we even see an eruption outside the caldera again? Those are of course just speculations, but it should tell you a bit that the English Wikipedia page is quite good, with a numerous link to articles. But when I look at the Icelandic page about this same eruption, it's made to look like rather insignificant part of our geological history. And I'm only mentioning this now because I heard this expert say up loud that events of this scale have always been and will always be a part of our nation's history. It was a good reminder, something that we all need to know who live here in this country. But the good news is that we might have to wait for 100-200 years more, according to statistics. But as for the statistics of my channel, I'm shooting more than I can process these weeks, chasing light whenever I can. But I will do an update about the Reykjanes Peninsula soon. I have plenty of new footage from there, and until then, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.